So the latest book in English is called Trust No One, and it's about a crime writer who's 49 years old. His name is Jerry Gray, and he's suffering from onset Alzheimer's. So as the story flows, he begins to lose more and more of his memories. And as that happens, he begins to think that the books that he wrote in his past are actually based on real crimes, and he actually cannot remember whether or not he has done these things or not. And the story becomes about him investigating while he can what he has and hasn't done, which is very tricky for him to do because he's not completely with it while he is investigating it. So he's an extremely unreliable narrator. So for this novel, more than any other one, this guy is very much like myself, and in a way he's based on me. We have the same job, we have a similar amount of books that we've written, have the same kind of house, we have the same taste in music, like he listens to music that I listen to, we have the same artwork on the walls. So essentially he's me, but older and married and with Alzheimer's. I guess at the there are differences between us, like, you know, the fact that he is possibly a killer, which you don't know until the end of the book. I know if I am or aren't, I'm not going to tell you because I don't want to give that away. But and as far as the book goes, you'd have to read it. He's also taller than I am, but we do have a lot in common, actually. It's basically an alternate version of me, which is why I was able to write it very accurately and sort of portray the life of an author and what it's like when you are writing crime novels. All the novels are actually set in Christchurch. Yeah, it's where I live, and it's a great city. It's a real great backdrop for when you're writing crime fiction. It's dark. It's almost like has a Gotham City feel about it. I mean, the city is more beautiful than I make it out to be. I make it look like a really kind of dodgy, awful place where if you were to go there, you probably wouldn't make it out alive. It's not like that. It is beautiful. But for the crime novels, you want that sort of dark, gritty background to make the story sort of, you know, race along and have more crime happening in it. The reason that I keep the book set in Christchurch so far is, I mean, it's my home city, so I know how long it takes for a character to get from A to B. I know what he's going to see on the way. I can describe it, and therefore I can bring you to my city, or my version of my city. I have a lot of fun setting the books in Christchurch. That's why so far they've all been set there. I think that one day I will maybe, you know, step outside of that and write something set maybe in the US or the UK or France. But at the moment, Christchurch is the home for my books.